Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you sine wave, cosine wave, square wave, and triangular wave generation in this video by using MATLAB. So here, let us begin this session with first plot, that is sine wave. So here, see, when you begin with any program, first we should be clearing all those data which was there in previous program. So to have a better practice, first of all, we should be writing these instructions where it will be clearing all screen, it will be close all those data, as well as we should clear all previous data. Now, we want to plot sine wave. So here our agenda is to plot sine wave, and that is what a function which is a sine 2 pi ft, right? So in that, whatever variables are there, that we need to define. So let us define a, that is amplitude. So amplitude that we need to insert as input, and in that we'll be entering that value. After that, here we need to enter value of frequency. So let us enter value of frequency as an input. So here you see I'm entering value of frequency. After that, in which time scale we need to plot it, that we need to define. So here I'm defining my time period scale. So that is starting from 0 to 1. And how many points that we need to plot for that sine, for that, in between that, we need to define that scaling. So here, if I take 0.01, in that case, it will be taking total 100 points to have a plotting of this whatever wave that we have it in this video, right? If I take 0.1, then it will take 10 points. If I take 0.01, then it will be taking 100 points. If I take 0.001, then it will be taking that as per 1000 points. So here we'll be plotting sine wave, which is having time period from 0 to 1. Now, let us have first wave, that is a function which is y1, and that is a into sine of 2 into pi into frequency into time scale into t, right? So it will be plotting this sine function, and to plot it, here I need to use plot function, and if I have plot t comma y1 function, then as per that it will be plotting this function y1 with respect to time t. So let us have a plotting of it. So here first I'll be entering value of amplitude, let us say it is 2, and let us say frequency is even 2. So now you see here we have sine, right? Now in this plot, I'll give title over here as well as x label and y label, right? So on y label there is amplitude, and on x label there is time, right? And title is sine wave, right? So let me give that title. So title is sine plot, and on x axis, x label that I am giving, that x label is time label, so time t, and on y label I'm considering that as amplitude, so y label is amplitude, right? Now if I plot it, you will be having again amplitude is 2 and frequency is 2. So you see now there is sine as a label, sine as a title, sine plot, and on y-axis there is amplitude, and on x-axis there is time, right? Now as I have told you, I'll be going to plot sine wave, cosine wave, square wave and triangular wave, right? So if I want to plot multiple plots, then I need to have subplot option. So here I'll be taking subplot option, Now in subplot, if I say 2 comma 2 means there will be 2 rows and 2 column, and first plot that will be 1. So 2 cross 2 means what? It will be having total 4 plots in this, and 1 is defining first number plot, that will be sine plot, right? Now I'm going to plot cosine wave. So let me copy this first. The reason is I don't need to write it again, as if I copy. Now my function y2, now that is cos. So in this second plot, that should be cos plot. So subplot is having 2 comma 2 comma 2. And here I'm plotting function y2, and my title is now cosine plot, right? So now if we run this, and if we give amplitude 2 and frequency 2, then it will be giving plot of sine. You see over here there is sine plot, which is starting from 0, and cosine that is starting from maximum amplitude, right? Now our agenda is to plot square wave. So to have a plotting of square wave, let me copy this again, right? And if I paste it over here, now I'll define function y3, that is a function of square wave. So here I'm just writing square, and this will be third plot, and this is what we are writing it with respect to function y3, and this will be a plot of square wave. And now if I save and let us run it, give amplitude 2 and frequency 2. So you see here we have a square wave, right? And its frequency is 2. So in 1 second, there are 2 cycles, right? With sine, cosine, as well as square. Now let us have third wave plotting, and that is a plotting of triangular wave, right? So let me copy this again and let us paste it. And we have a function y4, that is for triangular plot. And for triangular plot, we have a function that is showtooth function. I'll show you how to use this. So here I'm writing showtooth, and that is what, fourth plot. And here that is what we are plotting it with respect to t2 y4. And here I need to say it is triangular plot. So let us save it and let me run it. So here I'm going to give amplitude 2 and frequency 2. So now you see this is what showtooth waveform. It is not triangular waveform, right? So here all I need to do is I need to assign duty cycle of it. So if I assign this ramp with 0.5 duty cycle, then this will rise up to this, and for 0.5 second it will fall. So it will be having shape of triangular wave, right? So for that, in MATLAB, here with showtooth function, with this we need to write 0,5. So duty cycle will be half. And now as if I plot, then there will be showtooth waveform, you see, which is triangular one, right? So that is how these plots are there. Now if you wanted to have all these plots with proper amplitude assignment, in that case, I need to use grid on. So after y label, I should write grid on. And let me copy it. And I'm going to paste it with every plot. So that will be giving you idea about how we can have a plotting with respect to lines, right? So let me save it. And by F5 key we can run, as well as by this button we can run it. Now if I have amplitude 2 and frequency 2, you see we have sine, cosine, square wave and triangular wave along with the grid on lines, right? Now let us check it with some other frequency. So again I'm going to run it. Let us have amplitude 5 and frequency 5. So you see, now in 1 second, there are 5 cycles, right? With sine, cosine, triangular, as well as square wave. And as if you want to see this waveform with more time period, then in this, initially, we have defined this time period from 0 to 1. You can make it to 0 to 5 second even. Now, if I run this with amplitude 2 and frequency 4, then you see now 0 to 5 second, there will be a plotting, right? So that is how plotting can be done. Now, this is all these waves are looks like similar. So to understand that separately, we need to zoom in, right? If you zoom inside, then you can have proper shape. But let us have another try by which we can understand it exactly. So you see, this is how sine wave and cosine wave is there, as well as this is triangular and this is square, right? So here I have explained you 4 different functions: sine, cosine, square, and showtooth. And showtooth can be used to generate triangular wave, right? As well as how we can use subplot, that even I have told you, right? So in subplot, if you have 2 × 2, in that case, see, this is what, 2 rows and 2 columns, right? That is how we have plotted it over here. Now here in subplot operation, even you can use that in some other ways. Like you see, if I say 4 × 1, if I do this, then there will be horizontal plot that you can observe. Let me place it in all the subplots. So you see, there are 4 rows and 1 column, right? So that is how even we can plot this, as well as if you wanted to have that vertically, right? Then in the subplot, all you need to do is you'll have to place 1, 4. Let us run it. Let us give amplitude 2 and frequency 2. So this is quite difficult to see, right? That's why I have plotted it with 2 × 2 matrix, right? And see here, if you want to see this properly, then here you should be making this time period from 0 to 1. And now, as if I provide amplitude 1 and frequency 1, then you see sine is starting from 0, cosine is starting from highest value, 1 square wave that you can see, and this is what triangular wave, right? So that is how plot can be done. I think now it is clear to all of you how to utilize this subplot, as well as how we can plot sine, cosine, square, as well as triangular wave over here. One more thing that one can understand, how to utilize duty cycle, right? So before that, let me recorrect this with 2 × 2 so that we can easily observe. Now over here in the showtooth, if I say this is having 0.2 duty cycle, right? And if you further see this, how amplitude and frequency is there, then you see for 0.2 duty cycle, it is rising, and for 0.8, it is falling, right? If you change it further, you see 0.6, and now let us run it. So now you see, for 0.6 it is rising, and for 0.4 it is falling, right? By that scale, rising and scale falling, that is what we are defining by having that duty cycle over here. So this is how we can use these functions to have a plotting of sine, cosine, square and triangular wave in MATLAB. I hope that you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions matters to me, and based on that, in future I'll be making videos which will be solving your queries. So please do give your valuable suggestions.